Commander Bailey.
There is no anti-humanity conspiracy here, Ms. Al-Jalani. The Council's simply not granting interviews at this time.
My viewers are going to know that CSEC and the Council this are denying them one. Access.
Listen, lady, you think I like playing gatekeeper between the paparazzi and the politicians? I don't have time to babysit them, and I'm not here to hold your hand.
Tell her.
Well, I'm camping out until I'm granted an audience.
Camping out?
Fine. I hope you brought a sleeping bag.
Sleeping big. We know her. She's the one I was thinking of before.
Commander Shepard? Commander, humanity has questions.
Oh, you have questions, not humanity.
Damn press.
Mm-hmm. So you're keeping the peace?
Yeah, I feel like a glorified doorman.
Most people would see it as a move up.
Wedged in here with all the stuffed shirts? I'd rather be back down on the streets. I appreciate the higher pay grade, but I'm not a political creature.
Yeah, he is not happy with his current position now. So why did you take the job?
If you didn't want to be up, why'd you accept?
You don't say no to Councilor Udina. Well, maybe you would, but I gotta live here. I know, squeaky wheel gets the oil, but I didn't lobby for a promotion like some other officers. And not even sure why he picked me. Never know with politicians. I hate political BS.
Probably because you're the best. I just gotta bear with it, I guess.
Don't lose your edge. You might need it.
Oh, wouldn't mind an excuse to get my fingers dirty. It's killing me about Earth.
Mm. You and me both.
I haven't been back in years. Now I may never. If this ain't the end of days, it's pretty damn close. I'm up to my neck in trouble, but if there's anything you need, I'll do my damnedest to help.
Okay. Glad I started talking to him again. Now we got all these options. So you're not very happy about your promotion.
It was Udina who made you a commander, huh?
Yeah, he's become an even bigger shot around here. Got a lot of ambition. He suspected Executor Palin was conspiring against the Council and had me investigate.
Find anything incriminating?
Yeah, enough to arrest him. When Palin resisted, I was forced to kill him. Udina rewarded me with the promotion. And near as I can tell, being a commander just means I'm putting out different fires.
Yeah, right. Palin sounds vaguely familiar. I'm not completely sure who he is. How's the family?
You got loved ones out there?
He does.
Somewhere. Ex-wife I lost track of, and a son and daughter. They're still on Earth.
I'm sorry, Bailey.
Yeah, I'm just like everyone else. I'm losing myself and things I can control. And at the moment, that means creating the illusion of security here.
The war.
Is the Citadel gearing up for war?
There's a false sense of security here. Even people from worlds that have gone down act like they're safe. Well, I guess it's not just human nature. We all lie to ourselves to deal with horror.
And the Citadel?
Anything important going on around here?
You kidding? With the Reapers running roughshod through the galaxy, it seemed like the Council is in constant session. We got more ambassadors and dignitaries here than ever before pleading their cases. But that's just the tip of the iceberg, really.
Okay. So I have a heater I had to turn off, because now it's too hot in here. And, trouble?
Thought things were relatively quiet here.
Well, compared to where you're coming from, sure. But the war is being felt everywhere. Millions across the galaxy have been displaced, and most of them come here.
Must have you doing somersaults.
Yeah, already allocated the bulk of my men to customs, but we're still overtaxed, cataloging and processing them all.
Good luck to you, Bailey.
It'll probably get worse before it gets better, Bailey.
Yeah, if it ever gets better.
Noticed, Well, not necessarily markedly right now, but Shepard is having trouble being optimistic with everything going on. Liara is the optimist. And trying to convince Shepard that there is hope. But Shepard's not really buying it. Udina's in there. Who's here? Someone we can't find out. Nothing going on out here. Okay, Udina, here I come.
Commander, Councilor Udina said you'd be coming. If you'll follow me, the council is already in session.
Councilor, the Reapers are in our space as well.
Okay, we do have mixed.
Okay. Than any council homeworld.
But Earth was the first council world hit. By all reports, it faces the brunt of the attack.
How do you know this is the brunt? New Reaper fronts are opening up everywhere.
The reports are accurate. Earth was attacked. A full-scale invasion. And it's just the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
We need your help. Everything you can spare.
Earth may be suffering, but our worlds are falling too. The Turians have lost Tetris.
We must fight this enemy together.
Need I remind you that the last time we fought the Reapers, Shepard sacrificed the Council to protect human interests.
True, but in the end we survived because we followed Shepard's lead.
And what if that's not enough this time?
The reports are dire. If we throw everything we have at the Reapers on Earth and lose, what then?
I don't expect you to follow me without a plan.
Councilors, we have that plan. A blueprint created by the Protheans during their war with the Reapers.
Prothean? What is it exactly?
We're still piecing it together. But it appears to be a weapon of some sort.
And this is capable of destroying the Reapers?
Hope so.
So it would seem.
It's immense and intricate.
This is a fool's errand. The Protheans were wiped out by the Reapers. Clearly, the weapon is flawed.
It was incomplete.
Yeah,
there was
to
a
use
missing
it.
Component here. Something referred to only as the catalyst. But they ran out of time before they could finish building it.
Do you believe in this, Shepard? After what you've seen of the Reapers?
I believe in trying.
Liara believes it can work, and so do I. And while I haven't always agreed with Udina, he's right about this. We need to stand together, now more than ever. The Reapers won't stop at Earth. They'll destroy every organic being in the galaxy if we don't find a way to stop them.
You're shaking your head.
The Council cannot give Earth the military support it needs. Our own planets must come first.
The Salarian Union is convening a summit amongst our species. If we can secure our own borders, we may be able to aid you.
There's female Salarian?
Our are also engaged. Honesty is all I can offer, Commander. I will not make a promise of rescue that I cannot keep.
Shepard, meet me in my office.
I hope that's an offer of support. I'll be digging up what I can on this Prothean device, Shepard.
Those freckles are new, aren't they? I'm a little confused, though.
You're a bunch of self-concerned jackasses, Shepard.
Well, I can't blame them.
We may have a spot in the Council, but humanity will always be considered second rate.
How can they be so blind?
Commander, I can't give you what you're asking for, but I can tell you how to get it.
I'm listening.
Balavan's Primarch Fedorian is the one that called the war summit. He's your kind of man. Open to extreme solutions. Trouble is, he didn't get out of Palavan's system when the Reapers attacked. We don't know if he's alive. He's essential to the summit. If the Normandy could extract him without being detected...
So I'm a little confused, because we really didn't... maybe I'm remembering it wrong. We didn't meet with the Council at all in Mass Effect 2. And I thought they had said that the Council was an all-human Council. Maybe I misunderstood. Or just they meant that we have a human on the council. But I remember hearing that, and I probably said something during that episode that, it doesn't make sense to have a council with just humans on it. I must have misunderstood, because, they're not alluding to that at all, and, it's definitely not an all-human council. So anyway, favors for favors.
You want me to rescue his ass in the hopes he considers helping Earth?
Put bluntly, yes. I shouldn't even be telling you about it. But we need Fedorian alive, and your ship can get him. Save the Primarch, gain an ally. One with the power to grant you what you're looking for.
Well, the Reapers ravage Earth.
Your counselor was right. We need to work together. This is the best way to get that. Our intel says Primarch Fedorian is on Palavin's largest moon. Get in and out undetected, and he'll take care of the rest. Good luck, Commander. You're gonna need it. There is one other thing.
Oh?
The Council has agreed to reinstate your Spectre status. And there are certain resources that will be made available to you. Good luck.
Well, that went well.
It's a start. I'll talk to the others in the meantime. See if we can support this summit. Move things along.
Thanks.
Plus four Paragon. Oh, Codex. Can I... Oh, I can walk out here. I thought there was a windows. Jump into the water. Reaper capabilities. I'm sure they're vast. Citadel space. Oh my god, we have so much to read. And listen to. Palavin. The fall of Tetris. Oh, Tetris. Oh my god. It won't stop appearing. Renee. Okay, that was the last one. Well, the actual keyboard. That's interesting. Alright.
The Council. All I can think is that the more things change, the more they stay the same.
Mm-hmm.
I've always loathed that phrase. Fatalism. Not what men and women should aspire to. If we don't figure out something, maybe later will be an epitaph on a mass grave of 11 billion.
Yeah,
I know what I'm gonna do. What are you gonna do?
Humanity is as feared as we are loved. Hopefully that works in our favor now. I'll try to get financial aid from as many worlds as I can. Maybe manpower, a few armed ships. I'll institute a draft in our colonies and order all civilian ships armed. Work on the Prothean device will be around the clock.
Think you can get some leverage with the Council?
What's your read on the Councilors? Any angles I could pursue?
Councilor Irissa is not like her predecessor. She is colder. If she has her hand on your throat, she will squeeze.
Nice.
There you might find some traction. Practical, she might make Machiavelli turn pale, but that's a deleterious for you. Frankly, it's good Quintius spoke with you. His homeworld is in the most trouble, and he's looking for a way out. That speaks opportunity.
So he has a name, Quintius. Not just a Turian council member or whatever it said. How are things on Earth? Well, do we have any idea?
Any news from Earth?
There is constant news. All of it bad. The Reapers are destroying satellites and the old nuclear missile silos, along with everything else that could help. We have a handful of quantum entanglers spread out over the continents. All other communication is cut.
Political situation?
You're a Citadel counselor. Don't you have options when the others block you like this?
With Parliament destroyed and Shastri gone, I have more power than any human in history. But today, you saw how little that is. Rest assured, I will not be counted out long. I know I can move mountains. Do not lose sight of that, because the task before us is moving planets.
All right. Get some results.
Anderson would be proud, so long as you deliver. You think you can do that?
You need a carrot or a stick to drive a mule, and humanity has neither right now. Our armada is tied down fighting or fleeing, and with Earth's calm buoys gone, our economy's reduced to an IOU. But leave that part to me. I will lean on our colonies for all they're worth, and I can broker enough trade to repair and resupply Hackett's fleet.
And, I guess his personal situation.
Did you know a lot of people on Earth?
Many. It's monstrous to think of them being snuffed out, of course, but the part that gets me is Arcturus. I must have known most of the Alliance Parliament on a first-name basis. I required a second VI just to track all their birthdays and anniversaries. Rose Garden stuff, but to have it all gone.
Alright, well, good luck to you.
I should go.
I'll be here.
I can get in there now? Or is this where he came from? No, we definitely haven't been in here. Spectre Terminal. Oh, this is our little Spectre hideout. Spectre Outpost NSH-80. Wow. Where's the snack machine? What happens there? Is that like a teleporter? Or where VI stands and talks to me. Welcome. Welcome to the Spectre Information Processing Center. This terminal offers secure information access and support for authorization of covert operations or requisitions. Is restricted to operatives currently on active duty with special tactics and reconnaissance. Any operation requiring payment can be executed at the terminal nearby, which supports secure and untraceable financial transactions. Huh? Quarian Fleet Intel. Quarian Pilgrim Jen Volan Nar Nima on the Citadel received a large credit transfer from the fleet. Jen Volan purchased tech, including high-end weapon mounts and kinetic barrier emitters from several ship service centers. On Ilium, another Quarian pilgrim, unidentified, was observed searching for a ship traveling quote-unquote too close to the Perseus Veil. The pilgrim was later heard saying that his pilgrimage was recalled. Data suggests the Quarian fleet is withdrawing its pilgrims and upgrading ships for combat somewhere near the Perseus Veil. This could be a reaction to the Reaper invasion, but no formal offer or request for assistance has come. Intel suggests the Quarians may indeed, or may instead, be preparing for conflict with Geth. Huh. So this is like our little shadow broker type info thing. Spying on and observing people. Oh, I'm like, this is how much we have? Nope, we're missing a zero. So this is stuff we can get whenever we have enough money. 250,000 or 200,000 for this. Black Widow 1. The Alliance wanted to reduce the reload time of the original Widow rifle without sacrificing its stopping power. The solution was to increase the number of shots the gun could fire before it needed a fresh thermal clip. Heavy for a sniper rifle, the Black Widow's firepower more than compensates for its encumbrance. And the M11 Wraith 1. The Wraith is favored among mercenaries, pirates, and slavers in the Terminus systems. Its high-impact damage and sturdy construction make it a popular quick-draw shotgun. A variant of the M22 Eviscerator, demand for the Wraith is higher than ever, even though the weapon is banned in Citadel space. In order to lighten its weight, the Wraith holds fewer shots than the Eviscerator. And there's nothing else. So, the M77 Paladin 1. The Paladin is a reliable, durable weapon developed by law enforcement looking for a high-powered but easily concealed sidearm for undercover agents. Surprisingly small for its hitting power, the Paladin is a variant on the Carnifex pistol. While it has a smaller clip than the Carnifex, its shots are unquestionably more powerful. Well, where's the Locust? The Locust was like my favorite gun in the second game. So, whenever we have 10 times the money we do now, we can get one of those. Looking forward to it. Let's do here. Enter shooting range. Sure. Why not? I'm gonna shoot things. Well, the targets never move. Yeah, I'm not that good. Any better? Weapon bench. Right, did I pick up some new mods or something? So we can modify sniper rifle with some machine guns. Or shotguns. Zero of one. Shotgun high caliber barrel 1. Increases damage by 15%. Allows wider projectiles, causing more trauma on impact. Ballistically optimized to retain penetrative power. So we don't have anything else to mod on this, if I'm seeing this right. Is this the one I just looked at? No, I guess not. Sniper rifle concentration or extended barrel. Lengthens barrel, creating greater bullet velocity and impact. Increases damage by 15%. I don't think I'm going to use sniper rifle that much because I'm just... It's the first time my character has access to using them at all, and I'm just... it's not actually how I've been playing Mass Effect. concentration mod increases damage by 5% and perception by 25%, enhancing aim for a brief time. Biometric sensors and auto-targeting software adjust to the user's pulse and breath rate, assisting aim. Gotta love software. That's sniper rifles, assault rifles, nothing. Some machine guns we already have. Stuff. Shotguns. Didn't mean to hit that. Did someone yell though? Was that me? Guess that was me. It sounded like a guy though. I thought someone was coming in. I guess we're done. Well, this fog makes it very mysterious. Good for Spectre, you know, mood kind of thing. We've been here. We check on Bailey again. Talk to him about what the council, how the council reacted.
Commander Shepard, hope the Citadel's been treating you well. I'm still just trying to keep things in order. Feels like I'm fighting a losing battle.
I don't see an option to talk about the council.
We both have jobs to do, Bailey. I suggest we do them.
Yep. Good talking to you, Shepard.
I just wandered in here for no reason.
The Alliance have questions.
They do, huh?
Commander Shepard, Kalisa Bint seen in Al-Jilani. Isn't it true that you were on Earth when the Reapers attacked? How do you justify running away while millions of people on Earth die?
Punch.
Is that the best we can expect?
I've had enough of your tabloid journalism.
Oh!
Ha! You want some?
Oh, God!
You're angry.
Oops. Now you're unconscious.
But I came here to get help for Earth, not answer your questions. Stay down.
Oh, God. Well, that was a little ugly. Plus five, Renegade. I don't think it would help my reputation any. Hey, James.
You. Hey, Commander.
Big hulking man brute.
The Council's not interested in helping us.
Yep.
Something like that.
Why would they? Look at this place. There's no war here. People are whispering about it. They're talking about it. But they don't really believe it.
Yeah, well, even if they do, it's different being removed from it and being directly involved or affected. Kind of changes your outlook on things. This is not your kind of place, huh, James?
I take it this is your first time here with the elite of the galaxy.
I've been to the Citadel, but never up here on the Presidium. It's not right. It looks pretty, calm and peaceful. But it's not right. It's all just an illusion.
It was peaceful. Once.
But was it? Really? I mean, when push comes to shove, they're just gonna turtle up. Hope it don't hit them too, right? They'd rather believe in this than face the truth.
It is hard to believe.
I can hardly believe it myself. Like everything back on Earth was some kind of nightmare.
Yeah. That's what I hate most. It's like this place wants you to forget that.
So, you still want to go back to Earth?
Hell yeah, but...
But?
You were right. So was Anderson. We can't stop them alone. Besides, looks like you're gonna have your hands full convincing these pendejo politicians to help us. Hmm. And I'm up for it. Whatever it takes.
Glad to hear it.
I'm gonna head down to some of the lower levels where they keep it real. Hmm. You got some spare time? You should come and find me.
Maybe I'll do that.
Keep it real, James. Pendejo politicians. Oh. Leaves. That's different. Anyone else hanging around here? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that seemed like a female Asari from the voice. I'm not sure, though. I mean, not Asari. A female Salarian from the voice. Yeah, I kind of feel bad. That's not really becoming a Spectre, sure, but Earth Alliance soldier? Not really becoming. Well, let's go check out lower levels where James is, I guess. Lack of anything else to do?
Commander Shepard, please select a destination.
Should check the hospital one more time?
One moment, please. Now arriving at Huerta Memorial Hospital.
I can't help but think now the time has passed. We've met with the council. Maybe Ashley's condition has improved.
Welcome to Serta. Thank you for shopping.
They're still out of stock. What is she in here? Nope. I don't think there's anything else going on.
You can replace my leg, right?
Yes. But clone tissue replacement takes months.
Oh, they can replace his leg.
Oh, no.
I highly recommend talking to our resident psychiatrist before the operation.
At least it's temporary. Nothing like available like that now in this day and age. Did we go in here at all? Maybe. In fact, I think we did. Any more options, let me see.
Hello again, Commander. Here to see our patient?
How is Ashley doing?
The head trauma was severe, but we reduced the swelling quickly. These types of injury can go either way. You can go see her if you like. She's just down the hall.
Keep up the good work, Doctor.
You too, Commander.
Okay. Down the hall. I'm gonna go run down this hall. I don't know if we can get to lower levels.
Commander Shepard, please one moment, please.
Unless the bay is a lower level.
Now arriving at docking bay D24.
Now I'm guessing that the DLC really expands this because I really love the first game. I mean, you really just walk around the Citadel for hours exploring everything.
Supply depots, and then the main fleet comes in to occupy.
Someone walked up.
What does that mean?
Oh, the keeper pushed me.
Safe. They don't put engineers on the front lines.
But you won't be able to talk to us.
That would be correct. Alright, well, I am going to go back on the Normandy. I'm going to call it an episode. And, see you then. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.